The game is really up. What a week, huh? This video is going to blow your mind. The remote control of civilization is upon us. This is what we have been warned about, been told about, and it's here. We're right in it now. The whole situation is ready to click. The remote control, remotely controlling civilization, is here. And it needs to be sidestepped. That is why I have said over and over and over again, relocation, sidestepping. This planet, the controllers have a way to control the population of the planet by remote control. The same way that we use a remote control on our electronics. Okay, how do they do it? Well, it was shown to me last night in a dream, a terrible dream, how it's done. And it's no surprise to many, I'm sure, who are watching this video, who know all about this. There are those who want to control this planet, and I understand why. We're not attacking them, because again, death is a defense against annihilation. They want this planet to be an assembly line of death, a corporation death. Death.com is what they want this planet to be, and they want everyone to be good little lemmings. Okay. Predictable, controllable consumers from cradle to grave. And they want this whole planet to be focused on the perishable self, the impermanent. They don't want anything getting out of line. They want to control the planet. How do they do that? For example, this computer, for instance, your computer, all the computers. What are we against? Viruses, for instance, like a Trojan horse virus. Let's go back to Y2K. There are viruses, Trojan horse viruses, that will sit dormant in your computer, waiting for the activation code. They may be coded to be activated on a certain date that may be in the software, in the malicious software. So all these computers, everything's running fine. You think, hey, there's no problem. Everything's fine. If you look at the world today, society, everybody seems okay, right? I'm okay, you're okay, everything seems to be pretty fine. What's the big hoopla? Why are people talking about global control systems and all this stuff? They're nuts, right? They're nutcases. Everybody seems to be fine. Not exactly true. Everything's fine in the same way as everything's fine on a computer that has a Trojan horse virus in it that is set to be activated on a certain date, or by remote command to receive a command to be activated on the computer. Now, we know that the hacking networks, what they do is they have a network of computers that they take over. Viruses take over computers to utilize those computers like zombie computers at some given command signal is given, and then they're able to work together, the computers, to do their malicious mischief and damage. Now, what if to take the computers as a metaphor for human beings, for human belief systems, what if there were Trojan horse malicious software, so to speak, in human belief systems that have been coded into human belief, and that people were infected all over the planet, were infected with these malicious Trojan horse viral belief systems? What if those belief systems were coded to be triggered by some specific remote signals? Okay. Remote signals, for instance, like coming from satellites. And the satellites getting their signal from where? Well, let's say some remote command and control center somewhere, under the ground somewhere, some remote place. Signals are given, going up to satellites, the satellites beam the signals down. Now, we know that waveforms carry data, right? All the wireless stuff that we're using now, the smartphones, those waveforms, all right, energy waveforms, are data carriers. So those waveforms carry a massive amount of coded data in them. That's how this information and technology age works. So the satellites send down waveforms, okay, and onto the population of the planet. These waveforms are coded waveforms with various signals. These signals trigger the Trojan horse viral belief systems that have been embedded in people on this planet. And then that causes them to follow. It's like their software takes over, this viral program, just like a virus takes over your computer. This viral program that has been coded into the human system, belief systems, takes over the functioning of the person, and you have the zombie apocalypse right there. That is the zombie apocalypse, and I experienced that in a dream last night, and it was terrible. What is going to happen is there's going to be these symbols and frequency together. There's a combination of certain symbols and frequency, and the combination of those triggers this viral program in people, and they all begin to function like a hive mind with certain purposes in mind, and they all become like under hypnotic control is what happens. And then they're remotely controlled. You have a planet that's under remote control. That has been the purpose of the controllers, why they brought all this technology into this planet. What they've really been working on is to be able to remotely control the population of this planet and to get these people of the planet to blindly, hypnotically follow the programming that they've embedded. To very ill ends indeed. Okay, I experienced this in a dream, and I realized what was happening, and this sound, there was like a frequency sound along with some symbols that had some profound effect on everybody. Everybody went into a hypnotic trance, and I was fighting it off, trying to avoid it, and then I realized that I was almost blacking out. I had to get out the door, had to get out of this room. Otherwise, I would have gone under. It's very, very, very malicious software that's at play here. When we talk about the modern culture and how evil it is, the purpose of the modern culture is to infect people with these viral programs, these Trojan horse viral programs. It's very sophisticated stuff. The controllers are very sophisticated, actually. And they know how to do this. They know how to control a world, remote control. They know how to turn the world into hypnotized zombies who will simply be controlled. Their behavior will be controlled. What they do, how they vote, how they act, everything is remotely controlled. This is what the command and control technology, that is what the world has been trying to develop. The controllers have been trying to implement this on this planet for the last 50 years, very intensely. And it is operational. That is what I experienced. It was a terrifying dream. I saw that everybody had been turned into these zombies. It was like they were all watching in a room watching a television screen, and suddenly these symbols appeared on the television screen, these very odd symbols, like electronic symbols that we use for writing down electronic formulas and stuff. It seems like some kind of strange symbols appeared. And then some kind of a sound frequency also at the same time. And that triggered an inner embedded program in everybody, and they immediately turned into these hypnotized zombies. And then they all turned and were looking at me, and I was trying to not fall under the spell of this situation. And I realized I got to get out like this, and I don't even know if I was able to get out. It was a horrible situation. So this is the situation, why we have been warned about these times, why the warnings have been serious, and why people have poo-pooed them. The same way that computers who are infected by a Trojan horse virus set to be triggered at a certain time, everybody, you'll say, hey, your computer, it's at risk, it's infected, it's going to cause great problems. And you'll say, what do you mean? It's working fine. It's no problem. It's no problem at all. So people, no wonder why people will just brush this off and say, no, I don't see anything in society that's going to really lead to such terrible problems. Okay. And then one day they open up the computer and the virus hits and they can't use their computer. The computer's been taken over. And then no matter what you type on your computer, the malicious software is running the computer and being used, your computer is being used to hack other systems, right? And to do malicious damage, et cetera, et cetera. Your computer, the same way that the bodies here, the people on this planet, the personas, will be used to do very malicious things because they will be under the influence of these viral belief programs. And all triggered like that, just like a virus can get to a certain second, if it's the time virus, and at that very second, boom, suddenly the virus strikes and infects your computer, just like that, instantly. Instantly. So everything seems to be, you know, not so bad on the planet. There's troubles, normal troubles. But what we've been warned about is a very severe, sudden collapse of civilization because of these embedded programs in the belief systems of the planet, which have been embedded over the last 50 years, most specifically the last 50 years, through the popular culture of the modern times. It's a death-based culture. It is a death-based culture. What has been programmed into people is death, is to love death, okay, is to embrace death, is to bring about death, is to worship death, it's to focus on death, that death is life. It's a program that makes people think that death is safety, that death is salvation. And so all this violence and everything, the sex and the violence and these are all built up internal, these sort of walled off Trojan horse viruses in people. So people, everyone seems kind of normal. You go around, people kind of content, happy, normal. And you look at like these people, the programs they watch and the stuff, the video game, everything they're doing. And you realize, my gosh, they're just programming, being programmed. And yet they appear to be normal. And you know they're not. Okay, what happens is these programs are like, again, Trojan horses. They're set to be activated at a certain time. So up until that time, people seem to function normally. But when these programs are activated, these same people that seem to be normal can go berserk, can become demonic, can bring massive troubles onto the planet through remote control. Okay, and we know the technology is in place to do that. We know the sky is absolutely full of satellites, and many satellites that people are not aware of. There's all sorts of high technology, subtle technology that is in play right now. And from a command and control center, it's easy to send out the activation codes and to have the entire planet saturated with those activation codes right now. This very day it could happen. And we don't know when it's going to happen. We're not sure when it's going to happen. But this is why I've been beating this drum about relocation, relocation. Get off of the planet. This planet is bad news. Really bad news. It's been set up this way. It's been obvious. I mean, obviously there's been something very, very dark going on. Even out in the open, if you have eyes to see it on this planet. There's been something truly horrendous taking place here. It very, very malevolent. And we keep looking around and say, well, things aren't that bad. I guess it was all overblown. These warnings were all overblown. No, they were not. No, they were not. And what you've just heard here explains why. Is that the building up, infecting so many people with these viral programs to be activated so that the people then become controlled. They become robots, zombie robots, essentially. Doing things that they would not otherwise be doing. Just like when a virus takes over your computer, the computer is going to do things that you wouldn't otherwise want it to do. Would the computer be doing criminal activities and you can't stop it? You see, you can't stop it. Other than destroying the computer, as it were. So, we are in a situation that is truly dire. And this dream was, oh boy, it was just the feeling of almost succumbing to this and trying to fight it off and almost falling into unconsciousness and trying to realize I gotta get out that door outside, you know, get out, got to get out of the situation. This planet is under control. It is under control. The technology that we have on this planet now is remotely controlling human population technology. That is what it is. That is what its purpose has been. And it's beyond what most people are aware of. The operational status of this is certainly beyond what most people are aware of. But we get these warnings. We've had these warnings. Now, this was a very severe warning. I know the time is very short now where this these programs can begin to be activated. And you've seen these mass killings from people who obviously under some sort of remote control. Obviously. And that's not people try to say, oh, well, they're mentally ill, or is just something wrong with men, or something like that. It's nonsense. These people have had programs. They've been programmed. They've had these Trojan horse programs in them, and these are test cases. These are like laboratory experiments to remotely trigger these people to carry out these heinous activities. So these are test runs. These are test runs that have been taking, and more and more and more all the time. And then, of course, the popular position is, oh, well, it's the fault of guns, or it's the fault of men, or it's this or that. But never, never, never do they ever talk about what's really going on. Although, you know, some are, actually. There are some. It's not mainstream, though. Where I go a step further is relocation, because this planet is under the control of very, very deluded entities, ignorant entities, very, very ignorant. Who believe that death is salvation from annihilation. And they're completely unaware that annihilation is merely a hypothetical scenario that has no necessity to it whatsoever. The continuity issue has always been solved. They're unaware of the fundamental spiritual truth. They're unaware. They're ignorant of it. And this ignorance has taken over this planet. And we've been warned about that 2,000 years ago. We've been told for the last 2,000 years this time would come. And it would be so bad that even the elect of God were in danger and falling under the spell, which is what I experienced in that dream last night. I saw myself, you know, being dragged down by it. Very, very bad stuff. So what I say is relocation. That is what Jesus said he would do. He'd come back at the end of this age when things got to this point. To help us relocate, get off this planet. When they asked him, where are you going? How come you're not staying here? Why don't you stay with your kingdom? And he said, this world's not my kingdom. This world is under the power of darkness, under the influence of darkness. Okay, so that should make it obvious right there what's going on. He said, hey, no way. This planet is under the influence of the darkness. This is not my kingdom. I am going to my Father's kingdom, the kingdom of heaven, and I'm going to prepare a dwelling place for you. So that says it right there. This planet has been and is under the influence of darkness, the prince of darkness. And this plays out as this remote controlling of human population. And just to make sure that everybody is completely hypnotized into accepting death and continuing, have a continuity of death. That's all important to darkness, to fear, to ignorance. Believing that death is a way to minimize loss so that we don't suffer annihilation. And this is an unexamined premise. It's an unexamined premise. When you examine this premise, you get to the root of it and you find it's all nonsense because we cannot change reality, and therefore annihilation is completely impossible. Completely impossible. Therefore, we don't need to defend against it at all. And yet this world is under the spell, under the influence of this dynamic, this ignorant dynamic of needing to cultivate death, the cult of death, as it were. And it wants everyone to be under this spell, under this very, very heavy and dark spell. And they have the technology to do it right now. They have the technology. They understand how to program the psyche of people on this planet. and to then disassociate with that programming. So it's a Trojan horse, so the people are not aware. They're disassociated from the programming. And then have it triggered. There's a trigger on the programming to have it triggered at a certain time, so it becomes, takes over the operating system of the person. Very strong parallels to computers. Very strong parallels. It's something that has not gone unnoticed. It should not have gone unnoticed of what's going on with technology. Computers has a very strong corollary to what is taking place as far as control with people on this planet and controlling them. So this has all been seen ahead of time. So it should be, it should not come as any surprise at all to anybody that there's a plan to relocate, to get, go to another place. This planet is corrupted to the ultimate extent. Severely corrupted. This is now a planet for those who want to be extraordinarily loyal to death, based on an extreme ignorance and extreme spiritual pride. And that is no place for anyone, really. There's no place for anyone. Okay? My desire is that everybody gets free of this. Because nobody deserves that. Because nobody's left reality at all. No aspects of reality ever left. There's just a severe spiritual pride and ignorance that perpetuates this nonsense. But obviously not everybody will relocate. Those who are severely under the spell will think that relocation means annihilation for them. That leaving this rich milieu of death somehow means a spell annihilation for them. So they're terrified. They won't do it. But we have every right to relocate. Every right. Nobody has the authority to tell us that we cannot, to say that we cannot, or stand in our way, or cause us any harm whatsoever. We absolutely refuse any such nonsense, any such ignorance. We have the right to be free from this spell, the spell. We have the right to not be remotely controlled, not to be infected with these viral belief programs. We have a right to spend our time contemplating the non-necessity of this defense system, and the non-necessity of all hypotheticals, actually, except the one hypothetical of what if we didn't need hypotheticals. You see, we have the right to do that. Absolute right to do that. We're entitled to know our true identity. We're entitled to experience our true home. We're entitled to seek, to find what we seek, because our single purpose makes it possible for us. And we are entitled to find a new world that is not based on our thoughts alone. You see, it's not sustained by our thoughts alone, but sustained by the thought of God, the God of the Prime Creator. That is a new dwelling place that has a single purpose, which is truth, not a split dualistic purpose, not trying to serve both death and life. See, we have every right to happiness and bliss and safety and sanity, all that. We have every right to that. Everybody does. There's only ignorance, only whimsical ignorance could possibly assert otherwise, and that's a meaningless assertion. So it is really go time. It is really go time. And you will find yourself being able to make an adjustment. That's what will happen. What will happen right now, going forward, is you will find yourself, the way that you've done it before doesn't quite work. And it will start working less and less and less. Less and less and less. So your ability to function will become less and less and less and less and less. And you say, wow, I just can't seem to get it going anymore. It's not working good at all. And you say, I thought I had it, but I don't. You see, because we did not factor in this remote control, Trojan horse virus, remote control, remote activation of these controlling programs that infect the operating system of the persona, and then control that persona, and then have that persona carry out all these various attacks, basically, and bringing about mayhem on the planet. We did not factor that in sufficiently. So what we're trying to do, the way we're trying to function and deal with the world, we'll find it's not working really anymore. It's like, wow, what do I do? What do I do? What do I do? What do I do? Okay. what will happen is you will make an adjustment. You will just, one day you'll just say, hey, let me try it this way. Let me try this. And then suddenly, kaboom, you say, everything will suddenly be worked better for you than it ever has worked. You'll suddenly find an inner empowerment. You'll find an empowerment that you've been looking for your whole life, and suddenly you will find it. That is what is going to happen. But you cannot despair and give up hope and fall into self-defeating patterns as such. You must keep your inner sense of reassurance and confidence and faith in your destiny alive. You must keep that. You must believe in it. You must continue your faith in that. And then one day, soon, and it may feel really late, like, wow, maybe this is the last day, I just can't handle it anymore. And then suddenly you will have a perspective that will just click, and you will feel uplifted and empowered in a way that you never have before. This is what is coming. And it'll get better and better and better and better until you'll say, my gosh, I feel like a real pro. You know, I feel like I'm really empowered. I am truly empowered. You will feel a sense of true empowerment. True empowerment. That you have the capacity to sidestep these troubles, to not fall under the spell, to get free of this nonsense that's taking place here on this planet. Again, everything will seem to be fine on this planet, by and large, leading up to this triggering activation event. Leading up to the activation, everything will seem, well, you know, what's the big deal? Why should I be struggling so hard on the spiritual path? Why should I be working, you know, really trying to have success? What's the use anyway? Sure, I'm struggling. Sure, things are difficult. Seem to get more and more tough, more and more difficult. But hey, I don't know, maybe it's just me, that kind of thing. You'll go through that. But in the back of your mind, you say, hey, no, that we've been warned. We've been warned that there's going to be an activation of these viral programs in people through remote control, through use of satellites and other subtle technology we might not even be aware of. And once that happens, all hell is going to break loose here. Suddenly, all hell is going to break loose. What I saw was a sudden collapse of civilization, a sudden catastrophe here on this planet. A sudden, you know, that happened so quickly to defy all calculation of how could it possibly happen. The only way such a thing could happen is the activation of these Trojan horse viruses. That's the only way. Because a normal course of human events couldn't possibly happen that quickly. So the fact is that this programming has taken place. There's no question about that. It's been very transparent, actually, if you had eyes to see it. Very transparent. That is why it's important to keep the pedal to the metals. Keep accelerating during these times. Don't give up your efforts. Keep trying. And the breakthrough is there. The breakthrough is there. And it may be something that you almost tried a while back. Let's say you there's something you kind of dabbled in but couldn't quite get it. And you let it alone, and you haven't gone to it for quite some time, and then suddenly you'll take a second look at it, say, let me try this, and then suddenly, wow, it really works. So at some point you'll try something that really works, and you will have a complete reassessment of what's possible for you, and you say, wow, I'm really something. I'm really something. This awareness, this is really something. This capacity is really something. I really have it. Wow. Well, that's how it'll happen. But right now we are going through this very, very difficult time, where what we have tried just doesn't quite get the job done. We just feel like we're missing something. We don't quite have it. We feel there's something like a trump card that is over our heads. There's something that is over our heads that we don't quite get. Well, it's this information in this video. That's what it is. That is what is making us nervous. That's what I discovered. This terrible anxiety many people are experiencing. The stress, inner fear and worry is because of this triggering event. Is this capacity to remote control trigger these Trojan horse viruses in people. That is what is causing us to be jittery, very jittery. We look around the world and say, why are we so jittery? You know, I'm so nervous, I'm so uptight, I'm so jittery. I feel something really terrible is coming, but you know, world events aren't quite that bad. You know, I said, yeah, this state and that state and blah, blah, blah. But I said, yeah, but that's been going on a long time. There's nothing that quite accounts for this severe jitteriness except if an activation of these Trojan horse program, viral belief programs were coming soon. That would account for it. It most certainly would. And all this stuff may sound like science fiction, but keep in mind that at one point we have a certain science that is fiction, and then later on the science is developed and it's not fiction anymore. So back in the 50s, we talked about this kind of stuff of remote controlling populations and all this kind of stuff through waveforms, etc. And back at that time, it was science fiction. It was science fiction 50, 60 years ago. It's not science fiction anymore. You know, Dick Tracy had the, you know, the smartphones on a, you know, wristband. Well, we have them now, actually. Real. Just like Dick Tracy had way back in the day, 50, 60 years ago. So, stuff that was science fiction back then is fact right now. Scientific fact right now. And the capability to control the population of this planet is a fact right now. It's a fact. It's not fiction. So that's why we're jittery. That is why we're jittery. But seeing that, we become less jittery. That's what I've experienced. I'm starting to calm down. I feel less jittery. I've been very, very nervous, like a nervous breakdown, depression, super jittery. I can't seem to figure out why. Just anxiety attacks and all this. Because this is what is coming. This is what is coming on this planet. Now, having seen that, then I can say, ah, relocation really does make sense. It's not some crazy scheme at all. It's not some crazy scheme. It's very smart. It's very wise. It's the obvious thing to do. Now, I know there are a lot of people who think, well, we'll just go up to Alaska or Canada or somewhere and we'll be fine. Really? Really? Don't you think that satellites can reach you no matter where you are on this planet? The technology is there to do that. There are people who are trying to shield themselves from this. They realize it's coming. They're trying to shield, but you can't shield other people from it. And if there's so many people on the planet and infected with this and get activated, then all hell's going to break loose here. It's not going to be a fun place here. It's really not going to be a nice place here very soon. The niceness is about ready to come to an end. And of course, we're still... I met some people today that in a place that they had more of a farm background, country background, and the people were nice, friendly. I said, "Wow, you know, I haven't felt that in a long time. Silicon Valley is not a nice place. People are not nice or friendly here. They're not, and not compared to like the country folk and farming folk, etc., who will just talk to you as if you're family or friend, even though you're a stranger. They're not frightened. They don't have, you know, and just this calmer, slower, nicer sensibility. Say, wow. So that type of sensibility is again, going to really disappear on this planet. Could come to an end very, very abruptly. And that's not a good thing at all. That's not a good thing at all. we assume, oh no, things are just going to go along the way they always have gone along, and everything will be fine, and this, you know, not true. If you've really been paying attention, right, then you will know that that is not true, that the world has fundamentally changed. It has fundamentally changed. The technology is absolutely in place for global control. Global remote control, meaning the controllers, you don't have no idea where they are. You have no idea where they are. They could be under some mountain somewhere. Okay? And just sending stuff up to satellites, and then the satellites beaming it down to the planet. And the people have already been programmed here on this planet. They've already been programmed. Just like people's computers may be already infected, they don't even know it. They don't even know, but they've already been infected. And computer specialists who specialize in security, they might know. They might be able to find out. Say, wow, there's so many millions of computers are infected, because they're specialists in that. And the people on this planet who are specialists in seeing it, which, you know, have how many humans have been infected, they know. They know that, the infection has already taken place. They're aware of it, but the rest of the people are not aware of it. They're not aware of it. They think they're fine. Oh, there's something in them. It's just not quite right. Yeah, something isn't quite right. Something doesn't add up. There's something misshapen, something that is out of whack. Their thoughts cannot go straight, right? They veer off. They cannot get the momentum. They cannot follow a train of pure reason and clarity. They're incapable of doing that. This is just like, whoa, they just cannot, you know, just veer off like that. They can't do it. That should be a sign. Someone is not infected should be able to, I mean, I can go back to before technology to do this arrived on this planet. I can go back then and I can tell you it's night and day as far as talking with people, night and day. And you were able to talk with people, and not everybody, but a lot of people, and exchange thoughts and keep it straight. And you could take it to some depth. And people wouldn't freak out. They'd be able to stay straight with it, and then they would say, "Hey, you know, that's really deep stuff. I'm not able to see it quite that deep, but that's really, I can feel the depth of it." And then they'll say, "Well, thanks for sharing that." And it stayed straight. You could stay straight with people like that. You can't do that now, except in small, small sample sizes. That's for sure. It's almost like extinct, the ability to do that for people. But it was just naturally just a feeling like, hey, I can be honest and straight with this person. They're honest and straight with me, and there's no deception. There's no need for deception. We may not be on the same page, but we understand the book, and we realize that honesty is the best policy, and there's mutual respect and consideration. I met this old couple yesterday. And my gosh, you know, they were so straight and kind. They had never met me before. Never spoke with them really, up close like that. And they were. And then when I left, they said, "Hey, I wish you much happiness in your life." I was like, wow. You know, just the way that they said it, you know, was so pure and straight and honest. And I felt it. I said, wow, they really mean it, you know. And this is just natural to them. It's just natural. That's what it used to be like in a lot of places. I mean, these people must have been in their 80s. And you could feel it. You could feel the straightness of that. Now, they didn't know my beliefs about anything at all. That doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. You know, it came from the heart. It says, no matter what you're like or what you believe or anything else, I wish you the very best in your life. I really wish you much happiness in your life. As a parting statement, you know. I only been talking to these people for like a couple minutes, and that's how they viewed me, you know. Wow. That's how it used to be. That's how it used to be here. And that is about as extinct as the dodo bird in many situations on this planet. Now, for those situations that still seem to have some of that going, What they don't realize is much of the planet doesn't have that going, and much of the planet's infected with these programs, these Trojan horse viral belief programs that can be activated in a remote controlled manner, and then all niceness is out the window. They become fascist SS goons. They become goons. They start acting like goons, okay? They start acting like SS stormtroopers. And see, all niceness goes out the window. Now, I guarantee you in Germany, prior to World War II, that people who went to Germany said the people are very nice there. They're very considerate. They're very kind. You know, everything seemed to be pretty normal in most ways. The youth were very bright and sprightly and diligent and intelligent, and you know, it just seemed like, wow, what a great recovery Germany had. And what people didn't realize is the psyche of the German youth had been programmed with these viral programs. Okay, that was a test run for a global program that's coming up soon. They programmed the German youth through various means. The scouting program was one of the means that was used, but the mass rallies and all this, there's a lot of different ways that the programming was used then. And they had these Trojan horse programs in them. And then when these programs were activated, they were activated more directly then by authority. Okay, they had authority figures that activated the programs. Now it's done remote control electronically. They didn't have that at that time. But they were able to used various ways to activate these programs that had been set up, and then these nice upstanding German youths who are now, you know, 19, 20, 21 or whatever, young adults suddenly became SS goons, became stormtroopers, and all niceness was gone, entirely gone. They were ruthless. They were totally ruthless. They were what seemed to be without a conscience whatsoever. How did that possibly happen, you see? How could that possibly happen? All humanity was gone in these young people. So, exhibit A for the world, you see. I can tell you that the programs that the population of this planet has now is way, 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 way worse than anything that the German youth had been programmed. Way worse. The world's been goonified much, much worse, way worse. So you can have people, once it gets these viral programs get activated, who behave like barbarians. And you've seen some of the test cases of these people going into movie theaters and shooting people, going into an elementary school, you see. Going into churches, going into places, in various places around the world, unconscionable behavior. Totally unconscionable behavior. I mean, even the SS stormtroopers probably wouldn't know it on that. You go into they did just about everything. But to go into a movie theater like that, well, you know, that is just beyond the pale, obviously. Obviously. What's happened is a rogue viral program has taken over their operating system in order to do that. You see, they're like zombies. They're like zombies. And the world's been set up for that. Set up for that. So you may think, well, I'm a nice person. But you know, those people said, well, those stormtroopers, they're nice, reasonable people. I can talk with them. You know, I'm a good person. I'm a nice person. What do I have to worry about them? Well, wrong. Wrong. Don't underestimate the savagery of those who feel that they're about to be annihilated unless they glorify death and indulge in death, you see. Those who have this program that has got a control of them to think that death equals salvation from annihilation. Don't underestimate their savagery. See, give the devil its due, in other words. Don't underestimate it. Don't think that just because you're a nice person that everything is fine. It's not. It's really not. If you recognize the intensity of the situation, something that a couple of days ago I was able to recognize in the fullness and of clarity, just how intense the situation really is here, that literally we are absolutely terrified to unmeasurable extent about being annihilated, and that we believe to an incredible depth of extent, intensity, that death prevents this, that a scenario of impermanence where everything dies, perpetual sacrifice, it prevents this annihilation. Well, we literally believe that here on this planet. So imagine the intensity when we feel like there's a programming that thinks that death is going to be taken away from us. But basically the programs point out is what they do is they say that person there is trying to take your death away from you. You see, that person then is the total enemy, total wickedness. The world, you know, they must be destroyed. You see, that is the programming. Death must be reinstalled. It must triumph. Death must triumph, literally. What do you think those knucklehead SS goons were all about? Death must triumph. That's what Nazi Germany was all about. Death must triumph. It was the triumph of death based on a tremendous dread and fear that we might cast aside death, that we don't want it anymore, and then thinking that'll bring annihilation. So we are literally at the point where a global SS can be activated. They've already been programmed, and they can be activated via remote control by people we have no idea where they are or when they're going to do it at all. It's different. Like in Germany, it's not like there's going to be like a Führer and a figurehead that is really doing pulling all the strings. The strings are going to be pulled via remote control, electronically, using sophisticated technology, and we won't even know who the controllers are. Sure, there's some figureheads, you know, the political people and so, but they're just puppets. They're not really they're the fall guys. They're blaming them, you know. They're the ones who are going to take the fall for this. Actually, they're patsies, actually. That's a fact, they're patsies. The ones who are really controlling things are, nobody knows who they are. Like again, they're probably under some mountain somewhere. Remote control. That is what is taking place. And sure, they use political figureheads and stuff to get the people to think that they're following this figurehead, political figurehead, when in reality they're being hypnotically controlled via remote control. See? So the people don't realize what's going on. They think it's the leader who's telling them to do this and that, and they're following the leader and stuff. But the leader's under control also. Both of them are under control. And so the real controllers are the Wizard of Oz is hiding behind the curtain. The real controllers of this planet will not be known, will not be seen. They will be hiding behind the curtain, at least for now. Which is why it's necessary to bail out of this planet. Necessary to bail. Absolutely bail. Jump ship, bail out of the situation. In a legitimate manner, not in a knucklehead, crazy manner at all, but to be able to seek and find what you really want, which is safety, which is peace of mind, everything that you're entitled to. You're entitled to that. And if it requires bailing out on this planet, then that's what it requires. But the problem is now, it's not like a conventional warfare or something. No. The controllers, again, are sequestered away, hidden away in mountains or under the earth or in motherships or something. You can't get to them. You can't, you know, thwart them. It's not like some person you can get a hold of. And they're just running programs. And they're just doing it wirelessly to satellites. And the whole thing is being run wirelessly. And you don't know who's behind it and who's controlling it and how to stop it. It's not like you can have some war against it, launching rockets and stuff like that. That doesn't affect it at all. Unless you start knocking out satellites out of the sky. But they probably have some other technology too. So it's really way out there in terms of what's going on. Now, so it's better. Don't keep the Pollyannish attitude of, oh, we're going to find the bad guys. You know, these politicians or the banksters or all these, they're the bad guys. No, those are the fall guys. Those are the ones that you think are the bad guys. But they're not really controlling the situation at all. They're also being controlled. They're just being used. They're useful idiots, as a matter of fact. The banksters, the politicians, etc., are useful idiots. And you know that. You already know that. You know they're idiots. But they're very useful idiots to the real controllers. So why waste your time over useful idiots, getting all upset at useful idiots? Yeah, it's a waste of time, really. You topple them, that doesn't change anything. What really changes everything is to relocate, is to sidestep, is to get out of this place. So, I have had many indications that this will be possible. How it will work out, I don't know. I have not been told chapter and verse about it. So, I'm in the dark about that. But I've certainly gotten just a huge amount of indications and assurances that at the right time there will be some way to sidestep this nonsense. But we had better be clear about what we're talking about here, that the game has changed on this planet. And if you don't realize the game has changed, then you're in big trouble. So what we're doing here on these videos is just pointing out that the game has changed and then what to do about it. We're not trying to judge anybody. We're not trying to attack anybody. We understand that the ignorance that's driving all this comes from our brothers in spirit who, at this point, are still ignorant. Okay? They won't always be ignorant. That's for sure. They're just seeking to find something in a place they can't find it. They're just seeking for something they can't find. And they're all confused. So the way to help them out is sidestep their madness, their silly games. Sidestep it. Get out of the way of their silly games. Because getting mad at them isn't going to help at all. It's not going to help them. It really doesn't help them at all. You must understand the intensity of their fear. It doesn't get through to them. You can talk to your blue in the face. It does not get through to them at all. And your anger doesn't get, nothing gets through to them. They're running on severe fear, dread, terror, inner fear of annihilation, and thinking that setting up this kingdom of death is the most intelligent, wise, benign possible. A no-brainer. You know, that's what they think. It's a no-brainer. And how could anyone be against it? That's how they see it. See, and you cannot get through to them. You cannot change their mind. Not in the short term. You cannot. Long term, of course, everyone will eventually recognize the folly of their ways, get tired of it, and so tired of it that they'll just say, "Hey, I've got to recognize what's going on here." But on the short term basis, no way. You can't get through like that. I mean, did Jesus get through to all the people of his time? No way. Are you kidding? He knew that what was going to happen, Rome would come down and absolutely annihilate Judea, which they did. He knew did he go to the Roman authorities and change their mind about it? No, they weren't going to change their mind about it. It's not possible. You cannot force truth on anyone else. They will just get more frightened. If you try to do it that way, that's not the way. Jesus said, no, that's not the way. You know, follow me. He says, follow me. I know the way. Follow me. But he says, where I'm going now, you cannot follow now, right now, but later you will be able to. OK, Okay, that's another very important saying, that the place that I'm going to, now you're not capable of following me there at this point. But later on, you will be. Later on, you will be capable of it, okay? And this is later on. Folks, we have to realize that this is later on. We now are the later ons. We are. This is later on, right now. This is 2013. This is not AD 33. This is AD 2013. Okay, we have 2,000 years of later onness leading to this point. This is later on. This is the latter days. This is the time. And so this is the time that we will be capable of following him there, so to speak, to going the place where he has gone, going to that place. We will be capable of it. We understand the basic principles involved, whereas back then they didn't quite have it quite connected. You know, they hadn't, the dots didn't line up quite right. Even though actually in many ways the way that the ancients spoke about the situation in our minds and stuff is more advanced in the way we speak about it, more advanced in many ways, but they also had some shortcomings too. They had some shortcomings. They hadn't quite put it all together yet. But we at this time have the capability to put it all together. We understand high technology, and we're able to connect the dots. We understand how it can be utilized. We understand the psyche and how it works. We understand where fear is coming from. We understand the cosmos. We understand dimensions. We understand, you know, quantum physics. We understand a lot of stuff that when you put it all together, and then it becomes a wider and wider picture, we're able to then accept the bigger picture and say, hey, you know what? We're not stuck here. There are other dwelling places. We're starting to get that. There are other dwelling places. We're not stuck here. And this world isn't necessarily the greatest place there is, even though we're constantly told that by the controllers. Why? Because they want our death. Plain and simple. The business of this world is death. This world is in the business of death. Plain and simple. And that is seen as the most wonderfully benign, necessary thing possible. Even if it's not benign, it is seen as absolutely necessary by the ignorant. The ignorant always believe that death is necessary. The wise know that death is not necessary. And the ignorant cannot rule the wise. The wise are free and have every right to have their own dwelling place. Absolutely. So we're coming to the crossroads now. We've come to the crossroads where we now realize that this activation can take place, and it's out of our hands. We don't have some remote control that can stop it. So wisdom tells us, hey, wait a minute. If we can't stop it and we don't want to join it, let's get out of Dodge. Plain and simple. It's not a difficult concept at all. Let's get out of the way. And there's all sorts of stuff that's trying to scare us, trying to distract us away from what the problem really is. So that we don't really consider things in a very lucid manner. So the prophecies in the Bible are going to come true, by and large. The troubles to come on this planet, the tribulation to come, is going to certainly take place. And again, we may think, wow, it's just not likely. Given the way things are, again, we must factor in the embedded Trojan horse viruses that can be activated via remote control, and that can basically take over our functioning. Our operation of this body mind can be taken over by these programs, and we can then these programs then have a set view of who's the enemy and what to do to the enemy. Who is the enemy? And so right now we have normal discourse, we're talking, and once these programs are activated, people will start be completely polarized between who is a friend and who is an enemy and what to do to the enemies. That's it. There's no more discourse at all. There's simply the program saying we must annihilate, we must destroy our enemies by any means possible. And we will employ any and all means to do so. That is what will happen. That's a very startling situation. Whereas one day you have somebody who seems to be your neighbor and your friend, and the next day they're looking at you and saying that they must kill you because you are the enemy, you see. You say, where'd that come from? From this Trojan horse program that's been viral program of belief that's been embedded in them throughout their entire lives. The programming is so extreme right now. I mean, if I watch television for even a little while, I feel a terrible sense of being intensely programmed. Very, very virulent right now. Super virulent. Popular culture is so virulent right now. That's why I say don't watch the news, don't watch television, listen to the radio. Just chill out and try to keep your own counsel at this point. Because the programming is off the charts. The drums are really, really pounding and reaching a crescendo. But what was said earlier is that if you, those who stay with us in good humor and in confidence, that spiritual help will arrive in time for this. We will find that we suddenly, at some moment, we find our game. We find our game. And I say, my gosh, where's that game been? All my life, I knew it was there, I just couldn't find it, and now I suddenly find my game. And then, you accept it. You say, wow, that's it. That's what I've been looking for. That's what I've been trying to do. And you'll find it. And it may be a little surprising, a little shocking. And you say, holy cow, isn't this wonderful? Isn't this great? So that's what we have to look forward to. We will find our game. And we'll say, wow, this is wonderful. Finally, I found my game. This is how I always wanted to be. I always wanted to be like this, just like this. This is what I always wanted to be like, and now it's here. Isn't that great? And, but of course, many people on this planet. Will not find their game. They'll find the game that they think they want, that they've been programmed to think they want. They'll find the game that fear is telling them they need to find. They'll find that game. But that's a death-based game. That's not what we're looking for. We're looking for a life-based game, as it were. We'll find life. We'll find life. We'll find reassurance of life. And we'll say, yeah, that's what I always wanted. The timelessness of thing in itselfness. Of each instant being alive, completely alive and in one with that instant and not being linked with any other instant. When it's asked, how can we be free of death, etc.? Well, the fact is that in each instant, everything is alive to that instant. There is no death in that instant because everything is alive to that instant. It's only when you extrapolate that instant and say, well, everything in that instant is dead to other instants, that you get this belief in death, you see. In fact, there really isn't any death. But it's because we extrapolate in time, everything that is alive in each instant is alive to just that instant. And the next instant, everything is alive in that instant to that instant. And it's instant by instant. The instants are not linked. They're not linked. So that is why in each instant, everything is alive. Everything in the world is alive in that instant. It is alive to that instant, you see. There's no reference outside of that instant. There's no reference point outside of that instant. It's only when we think that instants are connected that we come up with this notion of death and suffering and misery and all of that. So you say, well, I'm you get somebody who's dying or something. Well, in any given instant, that instantaneous, timeless moment, everything in the world, including the person, is perfectly alive to that instant. Perfectly alive to that instant. It's all one. So there's nothing missing from that instant, and there's nothing dying from that instant. There's no time. It's right now, you see. And then the next instant is the same. And the next instant is the same. So at no point is there any actual death to what? You see, nothing is dead to the instant. Even when the body, so-called, is not functioning anymore, that non-functioning of the body is perfectly alive to that instant. Okay, perfectly alive to that instant. Everything is perfectly alive to that instant. So this is the secret of secrets, the explanation of how it is that there's really no death. If you see things properly, timelessly, there is no death at all. Couldn't possibly be. Where could it be? You see? In what instant could there be everything that instant not alive to that instant? No, there's only aliveness to the instant, always. Which is why the great gurus are so blissful, and you want to say, wonder, how could he be so blissful? Everything's dying. And they say, nothing's dying, really. That's why when Jesus says that death is a misperception, that nothing's dying at all. Nothing's ever died. I always wonder, what is he talking about? That's crazy, you know. I said, it's just, what is this? I don't understand that at all. But it is understandable when you recognize that the timelessness, the perfect non-judgment of the Prime Creator upon all hypotheticals, is this timelessness, and everything is alive in that timelessness to that instant, just an instant, that instant, and no other instant. You see, no other instant. And we can say, well, everything that's alive in that instant is not alive to some other instant. Okay, that is true. But in that other instant, everything in that other instant is perfectly alive to that instant. See, there's no instant that has any death in it at all. We're just playing tricks on ourselves, actually, thinking that there is. And that has to do with any suffering, any crime, anything terrible, all that, it's all the same fact. That everything in each instant is perfectly alive and safe and one with that instant. Perfect oneness with that instant. So this is very advanced stuff, I'm just showing that it's possible to get to that point and see it that way. And some explanation is better than none at all. You know, it's hard to process it for sure. But you can probably get at least an inkling of it, saying, yeah, instants are not joined. There's no real process taking place at all. No, each instant is completely free and clear, and no one instant does not influence another at all. Perfect freedom. There's perfect freedom. Perfect freedom. So no one instant does not influence another. Each instant is sovereign, entirely sovereign. We just sequence instances in such a way that we can presume that they're connected, you know, that there's some process taking place that is beyond the instance, as it were, that somehow is something, some other power that is forcing a change to take place and death to take place in these, but it's not true. Every instant is free and clear of every other instant. Everything within the instant is alive to that instant, is one with that instant. So someone is dead in that instant. The condition of the deadness is alive to that instant. That is what is with that instant, and it's not related or judged to any other instant whatsoever. So you can't say, well, that this is dead, because it's not being compared to anything that was alive either. You see, it's not being compared. It is alive to that instant. It is in that instant. It's not outside of the instant. See, it's included, completely included in that instant. And it's that which is alive. You see, it's alive to that instant. It's a different definition of life, isn't it? Very different definition of life. When looking at life from that standpoint, there's no such thing as death. Everything is alive to the instant. So you can see we're getting to very advanced stuff. This is very advanced. But we need to, because the technology in this planet is also so very advanced, and the capacity for mind control and the remote controlling of minds and people and populations is very advanced right now. More so than we realize. So we need to have advanced spiritual understanding at this point. That is for sure. And I need to wrap this up now so I can get to bed at a reasonable hour and keep on keeping on. But I tell you, the dreams are becoming extreme. Last 3 nights, just incredibly extreme dreams. But that's where we're at. That's where we are at. We are now in 2013, April, okay? We are now there. And it's not a joke. And these are the times. So again, hang in there. Be reassured. Realize that all this stuff is not beyond your capacity. It is not. It's not beyond my capacity means it's not beyond your capacity. The reasoning, the clarity, everything is there within us. If we're just willing to seek where it can be found, it's there. And at all times, try your utmost to have faith in the grace of God, the voice of reason, the Holy Spirit, whatever you want to call it. Ask that speak directly to your mind. It doesn't matter what you call it. It's just that you ask the truth of reality, the truth of God, speak directly to your mind. To say, I give permission, I ask you to speak directly to my mind. And you will find that then these really profound spiritual realizations and clarifications will come up for you, and you'll be able to see them, and you'll say, ah, I see that. Yeah, it's not too difficult. I can do that. I can get that. And then when you realize you can get that, then you can get other stuff as well. And then it all builds positive momentum for you. So make sure that you give that permission for the truth of reality to speak directly to your mind. And just ask that, whatever way you want to, affirmation, prayer, contemplation, meditation, in any way that works for you, that you're comfortable with, just keep doing that. Keep doing that. Speak directly to my mind. Speak directly to my mind, you see. And that counteracts the programming, the Trojan horse program, the terrible programming that this planet has been under, this awful programming. Stuff that just, you know, just makes you want to jump back in revulsion. It's been so terrible. It's all for a purpose. It's all for a purpose, and a very malevolent purpose. So ask the Holy Spirit to speak directly to your mind, to reassure your mind directly, and point out fundamental spiritual truths. All right. Stay with it. That's it for this one. Very great.